and hindered growth amid a pandemic. According to preliminary estimates, China's GDP grew 2.3% in 2020. It has also exceeded 100 trillion yuan, or $15.4 trillion, for the first time. There was a contraction of more than 6% in the first quarter last year, the lowest point in history. But this was followed by an expansion of over 3% in the second quarter and over 4% in the third quarter, hitting 6.5% in the final quarter of 2020.
The pandemic prevention and control work has achieved major results, and benchmarks for economic and social development were accomplished, exceeding expectations.
Ying says China's grain output reached a high point, while pork production sustained a fast recovery for 2020. There was also growth in industrial production, high-tech manufacturing, and foreign trade. Ying pointed to several factors leading to economic recovery.
With a population of 1.4 billion people and more than 400 million middle-income earners, China's domestic market boasts the largest growth potential in the world. The advantages of a super large-scale market are obvious. In the new year, no matter how the international situation changes, the domestic market is our foothold to more development.
The International Monetary Fund, or the IMF, predicted in October that global GDP would contract by 4.4% for 2020. It also projected that China could be the only major economy to grow last year. As economic expansion is important, Ning says China is keeping an eye on how it turns out.
China has been paying more attention to quality of growth. Officials say that boosting domestic consumption and promoting innovation are two key methods to support continued development amid uncertainties brought on by fast-changing external circumstances. Gao Wang, CGTN, Beijing.